This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Hey guys, welcome back to this brand new video. In this video, we are going to create a nice and simple photo slideshow animation inside of DaVinci Resolve 17 that is inspired by one of the Video Hive template, and I have given a link in the description. So my name is Vikas, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so before we get started, we have to do some basic settings. So click on the setting button and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. Let's go with any frame rate. So in this case, I am using this 30 frame per second, which is a normal frame rate. But if you want a smooth animation, then you can go with 60 frame per second. So I'm going to select this 30 frame per second, click on save. Now we have to create this animation inside of this fusion page, so we have to take a new fusion composition. So just go to this media pool, right click on that, click on this new fusion composition, let's call it anything. Duration make it 5 seconds long, which is good enough for one image or video reveal, and click on create. Now just drag this fusion comp on this timeline, just like that, and then go to your fusion page, and here we have this media out node. So just drag this media out to the side for now, and let's import our image or video file. So just go to this media pool, right click on that, click on this import media, and here we have to import an image or video file that we want to use in this project. So I'm going to use this image that I have downloaded from pixabay.com, and I have given a link in the description. So just go to the link and download this image if you want, and click on import. Now just drag this image on this flow window and just drag it to the viewer and close this media pool, and hit F2 on the keyboard to rename and call it image. Hit OK. Now I'm going to attach a transform node with this. So select this image, click on this transform button to add a transform node. Just drag this transform to the viewer, hit F2 on the keyboard, call it controller. Hit OK. So this is the image controller. You can adjust the image from here, and now I'm going to fit this image according to the project size. So we have to take a new background node, so click on this background button to add a background node and drag it to the viewer, and as you can see, this is 1920 by 1080 proportion, and we have to attach this output with this background to get perfect aspect ratio. So what we have to do, just take a new merge node, and in this merge node we will get 4 different points. So the yellow point is for background, green point is for foreground, and this is the output, and this is for effect mask. So I'm going to use this background as a background and this controller as a foreground. So connect this yellow point with this background and green foreground point with this controller, and drag this merge 1 to the viewer, and now as you can see, we have this perfect aspect ratio according to the project size, and click on fit. Before we proceed further, let me tell you, this video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creatives and curious people on the topic, including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and more. Skillshare offers creative classes designed for real life and all the circumstances that comes with it. These lessons can help you to stay inspired, express yourself, and introduce you to a community of millions. You can check out this course, Portrait Photography on a Skillshare by Jessica Kobeshi. In this course, you will join photographer and YouTuber Jessica Kobeshi and learn how to construct an amazing photos from start to finish for an in-depth look at creating gorgeous portrait that will stop the scroll on any platform. Skillshare is also very affordable for everyone. It's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription, and the best thing is that the first 1000 people to use the link given in the description will get a free trial of a Skillshare premium membership. Just go to the link in the description and check this out. Now we have to animate this image a little bit. So what we have to do, just select this merge one and click on this transform button to add a transform node, and this transform is going to be the animation. So hit F2 on the keyboard and call it animation and hit OK. Now just go to the end of this animation on frame number 150, right click on size, click on animate, or you can also click on this diamond button to create a keyframe, and go to very first frame of this animation and let's scale this up. So I'm gonna set this value something around 1.3 and just drag this animation to the viewer, and now we will get nice and simple animation as you can see. But this is a linear animation right now, so what we have to do, just go to a spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, check this size parameter, click on fit, select both the keyframes, click on a smooth button, or you can also hit S on the keyboard to smooth, and set the CTI at very beginning of this animation. Hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve, and close this spline window, and now we will get a smooth animation as you can see. Alright, and after that we have to make it blur. So just select this animation, hit Control plus a space bar for search box, and search for Gaussian blur or directional blur. So I'm gonna use this Gaussian blur, hit add button, just drag this Gaussian blur to the viewer, and now we will get this blurred output, and just drag this blur node right over here. And after that we have to create a text. So let's take a text node, just drag this text to the viewer, and here let's type anything that you want. And we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using Century Gothic font style, which is my favorite font style, but you can select any different font style that you want. And now we have to align this text on left side or right side according to your choice. So I'm gonna align it to the left side, just like this. And now I want to make this animation more interesting. So what we have to do, just right click on this text section, right click on that, click on character label styling, and go to modifier, and here just select this top line just like this and set it to bold, and let's increase the size a little bit. So I'm gonna set it 0.1 maybe. Select this bottom line and set it to regular. Let's increase the size of this font just like this. Set this vertical position right over here. All right, and now it's looking perfect. Select this text and just set it right over here maybe. All right, and after that we have to merge this text with this main output. So what we have to do, we have to take a new merge node. So take a new merge node, and I'm going to connect this yellow background point with the output of this animation just like this, and green foreground point with this text. All right, and just drag this merge to the viewer, and now we will get this text. And after that we have to add a drop shadow for this text. So select this text node, hit Control plus a space bar for search box, and search for drop shadow. So this is our drop shadow, hit add button, select this drop shadow, and let's do some settings. So just go to this inspector window, and here we have to set this drop distance 0, and let's down this shadow strength something around 0.3. All right, and now we have to add some particles on this output. So just go to media pool, right click on that, click on this import media, and this time I'm going to import this particle video clip that I have downloaded from pixabay.com, and I have given a link in the description for this one also. So just go to the link and download this particle if you want, and click on open, and just drag these particles on this flow window, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename and call it particles. hit OK. And now we have to merge this particle with this output. So let's take a new merge node. Just connect this yellow background point with this main output and green foreground point with this particle. Just drag this merge 3 to the viewer. And now we have to remove this black background. So select this merge 3, go to inspector window, and here we have to change this apply mode normal to screen. And after that, we will get this particle, as you can see. And now we have to create a matte node for this blurred output. So let's take our new background node, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename and call it matte. Hit OK. And now just drag this matte to the viewer, and here we have to create a polygon. So just go to the end of this animation, close this media pool. Let's increase the size of this preview window. Hold control and scroll down to zoom out. Select this polygon node and attach this polygon with this matte. And we have to create a shape. So I'm gonna create just like that, and then right click on this text, click on set key, go to very first frame of this animation right over here, and just select all the controlling points and just drag it outside of this frame. And here we have to set this polygon maybe just like that. And now we will get this type of animation, as you can see, but this is a linear animation, so we have to make it smoother. So just go to the end of this animation for now, and then go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, uncheck this animation, check this polygon polyline, click on fit button, select these both keyframes, click on a smooth button. Set the CTI at very beginning of this animation right over here. Hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. Close this spline window. And now we will get this type of animation. But you can create this polygon animation from bottom to top, top to bottom, left to right, right to left, that you like. All right. Now what we have to do, we have to invert this mask. So select this polygon, go to inspector window and check this option invert, and now we will get this type of output. And I'm gonna use this black section for this image output. So what we have to do, just drag this matte right over here. Let's take our new merge node, and I'm gonna use this background as a matte and this output as a foreground. So we have to connect this yellow background point with this matte and green foreground point with this Gaussian blur, and just drag this merge 4 to the viewer. And after that, I'm gonna place this blurred output in this black section. So select this merge, drag it to the viewer, go to inspector window, and here we have to change this operator over to in, and we will get this type of output, as you can see. Now click on fit. And now we have two different output. The first one is looking like this, and the second one is looking like this. And now I want to merge both the output. So we have to take a new merge again. And I'm gonna use this output as a background and this output as a foreground. So what we have to do is connect this yellow background point with this merge 3 and green foreground point with this merge 4. Drag this merge 5 to the viewer. And after that, we have to add a drop shadow just after this merge 4. So select this merge 4, hit control plus a space bar for search box and search for drop shadow. Hit add button. Select this drop shadow, go to inspector window, and let's do some setting. So we have to set this drop distance as 0, and let's increase this blur value 1. And now it's looking perfect, as you can see. All right, and after that, we have to do one more thing. Just select this merge 5, Click on this color corrector and add a color corrector node. Just drag this color corrector to the viewer, and here we can adjust the color of this image. So we have to increase this contrast a little bit. So I'm going to set this value 1.2, and it's looking much more interesting, as you can see. And now we have to animate this text a little bit. So just select this text one, go to the end of this animation, go to layout, right click on center, click on animate, and go to very first frame of this animation. And our animation is from left to right, so we have to animate this text right to left. So just drag this text on right hand side just a little bit. All right, and it's looking much more better. Just go to the spline window and let's make it smoother. So uncheck this polygon one, check this text one only, click on fit, select this both keyframes, click on a smooth button, set the CTI very beginning of this animation right over here, and hold this handle and just drag it like this. Now close this spline window and it's almost done. So we have to connect this media out with this main output just like this, and then go to your edit page, and our animation is ready for render, as you can see. Alright, so just go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the loop button, and let's take a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon to get notified when I will upload my new video. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.